What happens to my garbage? Every 2 weeks, a collection crew shows up to pick up your garbage. Up to 40 trucks make more than 1,000 stops a day. Each waste collection operator walks 21 kilometers during a 10-hour shift, a half marathon, while lifting 10 tons of material. The collection vehicles crush materials to reduce load volume and decrease trips to the landfill. When trucks are full, they head to the Trail Road Waste Facility southwest of Barrhaven. All trucks are weighed when they arrive and again when they leave, so the city can track how much waste is entering the facility. On average, Trail Road receives 1,000 tons of garbage per day.
The vehicles, when they arrive on our landfill, drive up onto our scale house here behind me.
The scale attendants process 600 vehicles a day. They guide everyone on where they need to go and take payments from those customers who have to pay a tipping fee.
At the small loads area, materials can be dropped off for reuse or recycling. There's no charge for glass, metal, plastic, tires, scrap metal, and electronic waste. Brush and cardboard are accepted for a small fee. Any vehicle that brings in a load for disposal, big or small, gets directed to the tipping face.
The tipping face is the active zone at the edge of a landfill. The amount of garbage we're standing on grows every day, which means the tipping face moves continuously.
Collection trucks head back to the scale house after they are emptied. Heavy equipment operators compact newly added waste with an enormous bulldozer and a packer to flatten it as much as possible. Other measures are taken for safety, sustainability, and odor control.
We put up fences around the site to stop garbage, such as plastic bags, from flying onto the highway nearby. We hire a company that bring in hawks and falcons to deter the seagulls from coming onto the site and spreading the garbage. So our tipping face at night is covered with a tarp, soil, and wood chips.
Once an area is full, it is sealed with a raincoat-like barrier and various layers of soil, then topped with grass. The Trail Road landfill opened in 1980, and the area that is now full is much bigger than the active area. The overall waste footprint is 85 hectares, more than 150 football fields wide. But how much space is left? In 2021, we learned that our landfill could reach capacity as early as between 2036 and 2038 if we keep doing what we're doing. But if all residents strive to create less garbage together, it can last longer. So, what else happens at Trail Road? The city's waste facility is a highly engineered site. A lot of effort goes into protecting the environment. Groundwater is monitored carefully, and leachate is collected and pre-treated right at Trail. Leachate, or garbage juice in layman's terms, is a mix of liquids from wet waste and added rain or snow. After 24 hours in a settling basin, tankers take it to ROPEC, the city's wastewater treatment plant. PowerTrail is a private-public partnership that generates electricity from landfill gas, powering 6,000 homes and businesses. CO2 and methane form when organic matter decomposes in the absence of oxygen. Wells capture these harmful greenhouse gases to prevent them from entering the atmosphere. At an outdoor composting facility, leaf and yard waste is turned into potting soil and then sold to residents so they can reuse it in their own yards or community gardens. The administration building was designed with a silver LEED green building certification, housing offices in the front and a garage in the back.
This building here behind me is where we store, clean, and maintain our heavy equipment, such as the water truck for dust control, our rock trucks for soil management.
And then, of course, our compactor and bulldozer. Our compactor weighs 56 tons. That's the weight of 6 elephants.
After a long day, they are stored in the garage. At 7 a.m. the next morning, the waste facility will open again, and the collection crews will bring in more garbage. Your garbage. Good news? If you make full use of your green bin and recycling bins, you can keep 75% of your waste out of the landfill. But the best way to reduce waste is to avoid creating it. Buy less, repair more, choose reusable containers, refuse unnecessary packaging, sell, swap, donate, re-gift, or repurpose what you no longer need. With your help, our landfill will last longer. Not sure what goes in which bin? Visit ottawa.ca/wasteexplorer.